استمسك بحبل الله، استمسك بحبل الله.
Hold tight to the rope of Allah. Hold tight to the rope of Allah.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى the topic that I will be speaking about is الافتراق، أما الخلاف وعلاجه، the خلاف، the disputes and the cures to it إن شاء الله تعالى. The topic is very vast and it's very big, and I won't be able to speak about it from all of its corners or explain it very well due to it being a very big topic. But what I will do inshallah ta'ala is talk about two points regarding it. The first one is dammul iftiraq, how Allah rebuked and spoke against disunity. And the second inshallah ta'ala is haqiqatul iftiraq, haqiqatul tafarruq. What is the reality and what is the true definition of the word iftiraq? Because if a person doesn't perceive something the way it should be perceived and doesn't have a correct understanding of it, what will happen is they will assume something that isn't iftiraq, disunity, he thinks this is disunity. And something that is a disunity, he will think it is not, and vice versa. So inshallah ta'ala, we require and we need, as the usuliyin they say, al-hukmu ala shay'un far'un an tasawwuri, to give a ruling on a matter, there has to be perception, there has to be a correct perception of it. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to start by talking about dhammul iftiraq, dhammul tafarruq, and then I'll speak about haqiqatul tafarruqi later. Iftiraq is the diddul itilaf. Iftiraq is the opposite to itilaf, which is to be unified, is to be disunified, is to the opposite to it, is to separate and become groups and cut off. تهذيب اللغات الأزهري مقاييس اللغة لسان العرب and Arabic dictionaries, they mention that iftiraq is the opposite to ائتلاف. And there are many nusus, evidences from the kitab and the sunnah that urge us to become together and to come together. And there are many evidences that tell us to stay away from becoming groups and dividing. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ آيَاتِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ وَلْتَكُنْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَلْتَكُنْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّةٌ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ ولا تكونوا كالذين تفرقوا واختلفوا من بعد ما جاءهم البينات وأولئك لهم عذاب عظيم. In those three verses, the first verse, Allah تبارك وتعالى says to us, واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا. All of you hold on to the rope of Allah. That ayah, the first benefit that we take from it is, Allah is ordering us as a whole. We all come together and we hold on to that rope. The second benefit that we take from it is there's something that we need to all hold on to. We can't be unified and we can't come together for the mere sake we want. There has to be something which we unify on. And that is the rope of Allah. So the unity, if it's not based on the rope of Allah, it is not mahmood, it's not praiseworthy. Because Allah spoke against the Jews, Allah said about them, تَحْسَبُهُمْ جَمِيعًا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى. When you look at them from the apparent, they look like they're together, but their hearts are not together. Meaning they don't believe the same thing. So being those who are together for the sake of just being together, when there is nothing, they're not together on a correct ideology, is not praiseworthy. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah said regarding this ayah, Ibn Kathir said, أَمَرَهُمْ بِالْجَمَاعَةِ. Allah ordered us in this verse to become a jama'ah, a group. ونهاهم and Allah تبارك وتعالى prohibited us عن التفرقة to become groups and to divide. وقد وردت الأحاديث المتعددة بالنهي عن التفرق والأمر بالاجتماع. There have come many evidences that have prohibited us from becoming groups and has ordered us to unify والائتلاف and to come together. كما as it's in في صحيح مسلم من حديث السهيل ابن أبي صالح عن أبيه عن أبي هريرة. Ibn Kathir said, as it's been narrated in Sahih Muslim, from the Suhail ibn Abi Salih, who narrated from his father Abi Salih, who narrated from Abi Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna Allah, verily Allah, yarda lakum thalathan. Allah is pleased for you three. Wa yaskhatu lakum thalathan. And Allah dislikes for you three. Yarda lakum, Allah is pleased for you. Pay attention again. An ta'buduhu wa la tushriku bihi shay'an. That came first. The thing we're unifying upon is this, that we worship Allah alone and we do not associate partners with Him. وَأَن تَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ And that we all hold onto the rope of Allah together. وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا And do not become groups. وَأَن تُنَاصِحُوا مَن وَلَّاهُ اللَّهُ أَمْرَكُمْ And that you guys give nasiha, advice to whoever Allah makes leadership over you. Ibn Kathir then said, وَيَسْقَطُ لَكُمْ ثَلَاثًا He said that the Prophet said, Allah dislikes three for you. What are they? قِيلَ وَقَالْ He said, she said. وَكَثْرَةَ السُّؤَالِ Asking too much. وَإِضَاعَةَ الْمَالِ And also wasting wealth. Ibn Kathiri's speech, I want you to understand, please. It's very important. He said, وَقَدْ ضُمِنَتْ لَهُمُ الْعِصْمَةِ We have been promised that we will be infallible. We will be errorless. When? عند اتفاقهم when we all unite. When we're together, we don't have no mistakes. We're errorless as a whole, not individually, but as a whole. It's impossible that we all together come together on a matter and that there is a mistake with us. We're infallible. وَقَدْ ضُمِنَتْ They have been promised لَهُمُ الْعِصْمَةُ That they are infallible عند اتفاقهم من الخطأ from mistakes. كَمَا وَرَدَتْ بِذَلِكَ الْأَحَادِيثُ الْمُتَعَدِّدَةُ أَيْضًا As many extensive narrations have indicated that. وَخِيفَ عَلَيْهِمْ And it was scared for us, الافتراق. Ibn Kathir says, it was feared for us that we become groups and divide and cut apart. وَالِاخْتِلَافِ وَقَدْ وَقَعَ ذَلِكَ And that matter took place. فِي هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ In this ummah. فَافْتَرَقُوا They became groups. عَلَى 73 فِرْقَةِ They became 73 sects. The ummah is two types, brothers. And sisters, ummatul da'wa and ummatul ijaba. Ummatul da'wa, the disbelievers fall under it. Ummatul ijaba are those who have accepted the message. The hadith is, which one is it referring to? Ummatul da'wa, ummatul ijaba? Ummatul ijaba is referring to, it's talking about the Muslims. The 73 sects is not the disbelievers, it's the Muslims. So they will be divided into 73 sects. Minha, from that 73 is what? Firqatul najiyatul ilal jannah. A sect who are going to be saved and they will be taken to Jannah. وَمُسَلَّمَةٌ And they will be protected from مِنْ عَذَابِ النَّارِ From the punishment of the hellfire. وَهُمُ الَّذِينَ And they are those. Anyone who reads that ayah and looks at that hadith or even the speech of Ibn Kathir underlines that point. It sticks out for you. Because he gives you who are the ones who are going to be saved from the hellfire and those who are going to enter Jannah. Of course, he took it from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. He said, وَهُمُ الَّذِينَ And they are the ones. عَلَى مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ It is the one who is upon that which the messenger was upon. وَأَصْحَابُهُ And his companions. So the division and the disputes and the khilafat that are occurring are due to the people not taking their evidences and their religion and their belief from where? From the messenger عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ And they're not backing it up with the understanding of the sahabas. Now the question that arises as is istidrat. I'm slightly going to go off topic, which is كَيْفَ يُعْرَفُ مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَأَصْحَابَهُ How do we recognize that which the Prophet was upon and his companions? That's a question itself. If that is what will save us from becoming, not dividing and not becoming groups, that question that arises is how can we be How can we be saved? Or how can we recognize that which the Prophet and his companions were upon? So we don't become groups and sects. Abu Qasim al-Taymi rahimahullah, he has a book called Al-Hujjah fi Bayan al-Mahajjah. He says in his book, when it came to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, man kana ala mithli ma ana alayhi al-yawma wa ashabi. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, sataftariqu ummati ala 73 firqa. My ummah will be divided into 73 sects. Kulluha fi al-nar. All of them are in the hellfire except one. The Sahabas, they said, Ya Rasulullah, who are the saved ones? The Prophet said, whoever is upon that which I am upon, and that which my companions are upon. Abu Qasim al-Taymi, Qawam al-Sunnah, he mentions how that part of the hadith, he explains to you how to recognize what the Prophet and his companions were upon. He says, فَلَا بُدَّ it is necessary. مِنْ تَعَرُّفِ مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَأَصْحَابُهُ وَلَيْسَ طَرِيقُ مَعْرِفَتِهِ إِلَّا النَّقْلَ فَيَجِبُ الرُّجُوعُ إِلَى ذَلِكَ. He says, it is necessary to know that which the messenger was upon. And that which his companions were upon is necessary. Of course it is. Because it's what's going to make us unite upon the truth. It is what's going to bring us back to the haqq. And then he tells us, وَلَيْسَ and there isn't. طَرِيقُ مَعْرِفَتِهِ there is no way to recognize that which the Prophet was upon. And the companions, إِلَّا النَّقْلَ except through the text. The way to recognize that which the Prophet was upon and the Sahabas were upon is by the text. And we'll explain that more in details, inshallah. فَيَجِبُ due to that, it is obligatory on what? الرُّجُوعُ إِلَى ذَلِكَ to take the matter back to those people who are أصحاب النقل. The people who can transmit it to you. His speech goes on. وَقَدْ قَالَ النَّبِيُّ the messenger said, لَا تُنَازِعُ الْأَمْرَ أَهْلَهُ do not dispute the people who have the leadership of a matter. He's trying to refer to here as the people who know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's traditions and the Sahaba's traditions. Don't dispute with them. They're the ones that are going to transmit it to you. The reason why Abu Qasim al-Taymi rahimahullah, he's bringing this and it's needed is because there are those who try to base their belief system on their logic and their intellect, who think by coming with what the brain shows them, at-tahsin wa at-taqbih al-aqli, whatever the mind beautifies and whatever the mind says that is ugly, then that's the religion. That is the religion. Abu Qasim al-Taymi rahimahullah is saying no. The way to know that which is going, that the Prophet was upon and his companions is by text. Good. فَكَمَا يُرْجَعُ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ مَذَاهِبِ الْفُقَهَا if you wanted to know a mas'ala that the scholars of fiqh believe, who do you take it back to? You take it back to the fuqaha. You don't take it back to the lughawiyin. You don't take it back to the sarfiyin. You don't take it back to the bulagha. You take it back to the fuqaha. If you need a mas'ala fiqhiyya, if a madhab of fuqaha believe a matter, take it to its people. Good. Why? Fuqaha الَّذِينَ صَارُوا قُدْوَةً فِي هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ إِلَى أَهْلِ الْفِقْهِ وَيُرْجَعُ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ اللُّغَةِ if you want to know a language-based matter, who do you take it back to? إِلَى أَهْلِ اللُّغَةِ to the people of the language. وَيُرْجَعُ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ النَّحْوِ if you want to know a grammatical matter, if you want to know a grammatical matter, you take it back to the ulama of the language. إِلَى أَهْلِ النَّحْوِ فَكَذَلِكَ and like that. يَجِبُ أَن يُرْجَعَ فِي مَعْرِفَةِ مَا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَأَصْحَابُهُ إِلَى أَهْلِ النَّقْلِ وَالرِّوَايَةِ the same way, if you want to know that which the messenger was upon and the Sahabas were upon, bring it back to the people of text, Ahlul Hadith, Ahlul Riwaya, the people who know the Prophet's traditions. لِأَنَّهُمْ why? عُنُوا بِهَذَا الشَّأْنِ they gave effort and time to this field. وَاشْتَغَلُوا بِحِفْظِهِ and they worked hard on memorizing it. وَالتَّفَحُّصِ and they also researched, they checked وَنَقْلِهِ and its text. They looked at the hadith, they picked it up and separated. This is ضعيف, take this out. Fulan is in this hadith, it's weak. They're the ones who transmitted it from us, to us. And then he said, وَلَوْ لَاهُمْ if it wasn't for them. لَنْ دَرَسَ الْعِلْمُ this knowledge would have perished. Of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So here we take from this, brothers, that the path to know that which the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام was upon is by what? By going back to the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the sahabas and the ulama who are mawthuqun, who are trusted, who are reliable, who transmit to us and say, this is the madhab of the salaf, we'll take it from them. Now, going back to the topic again, inshallah. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Quran, Inna ad-deena 'inda Allahi al-Islam. The religion of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is Islam. There is no other religion which Allah accepts. وَمَا اخْتَلَفَ الَّذِينَ And the people who have disputed one another from the people who were given the books previously, they disputed one another one. When? إِلَّا مِن بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ الْعِلْمُ بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ They disputed each other after knowledge came to them, and the reason why they disputed one another was بَغْيًا بَيْنَهُمْ It was due to transgression. It was exceeding one's boundaries. وَمَنْ يَغْفُرُ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ Anyone who disbelieves in the verses of Allah, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ Allah is fast in his judging. This ayah, Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he said, أَيْ بَغَى بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ Part of them transgressed on the other group. فَاخْتَلَفُوا They disputed each other فِي الْحَقِّ In the truth. They disputed one another in the truth. Why? لِتَحَاسُدِهِمْ Because of hate that they have towards one another. وَتَبَاغُضِهِمْ An enmity. You see, وَتَدَابُرِهِمْ And turning their backs on one another. Pay attention, brothers. فَحَمَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ بُغْضَ الْبَعْضِ The hate that they had on one another, the hate in which they had for one another, it took them to oppose one another. فَحَمَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ بُغْضُ الْبَعْضِ الْآخَرِ عَلَى مُخَالَفَتِهِ Because he hates this person. Personally, he hates him. His hate has automatically forced him to go against this person. Good. فِي جَمِيعِ أَقْوَالِهِ In everything that this person says. Because I don't like this person, I'm going to go against everything he says. وَأَفْعَالِهِ His actions. وَإِنْ كَانَتْ حَقًا Even if it's the truth. Even if this person brings a matter which is the haqq, and I won't take it. If you go to قَوَاعِدُ النُّورَانِي by Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, and also in his مُجْمَلْ اِعْتِقَادِ اهل السنة, he brings that Ibn Taymiyyah, and also in his Minhaj Sunnah Nabawiyyah, the 35th volume, page 100 around there, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentions, alayhi rahmatullah, he mentions that, and use this ayah with another ayah, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ لَيْسَتِ النَّصَارَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَقَالَتِ النَّصَارَ لَيْسَتِ الْيَهُودُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَهُمْ يَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ The Jews and the Christians were both saying about one another, you're upon nothing, and the other was saying, you're upon nothing, and they're all reading the book. Meaning that Ibn Taymiyyah said that, the haqq is with them, they have the haqq with them. One might have the haqq. He won't say, look, I don't personally agree with you as an individual, but wallahi, this matter your haqq. Because the haqq is Allah's property of the believer. Al-haqqu dalat al-mu'min. The haqq is what? It's the lost property of the believer. Whenever he finds, whoever utters it, he takes it from him. Na'am. So they don't do that. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He said in another ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا Those people who divided their religion and they became groups, لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ Muhammad, you have nothing to do with them. إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُمْ their matter is to Allah. ثُمَّ يُنَبِّئُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ Allah will tell them the day of judgment what they used to do. This ayah has a different form of recitation. Allah tabarak ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ There's another qira'ah which is, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَارَقُوا دِينَهُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ And there's another qira'ah which says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَارَقُوا دِينَهُمْ This too seems like it is not referring to, because when you say, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَارَقُوا دِينَهُمْ It can have the meaning which is those who have, a group have become Muslims and another group became non-Muslims. So is the ayah referring to the Muslims or is it referring to the non-Muslims? Ibn Kathir and Ibn Jarir al-Tabari says it refers to the Muslims as well. Ibn Kathir says, وَالظَّاهِرُ What is apparent is, أَنَّ الْآيَةَ عَامَّةَ The ayah is general. فِي كُلِّ On everybody. Not Muslims or non-Muslims. فِي كُلِّ مَنْ فَارَقَ دِينَ اللَّهِ Anyone who goes against Allah's religion. وَكَانَ مُخَالِفًا لَهُ And he opposes it. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ بَعَثَ رَسُولَهُ Allah has sent his messenger. بِالْهُدَى With guidance. وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ And the true religion. Why? لِيُظْهِرَهُ To make it apparent عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهُ Over all religions. وَالشَّرْعُهُ وَاحِدٌ The Prophet's legislation is one. لَاخْتِلَافَ فِيهِ There's no differences in it. وَلَافْتِرَاقَ فَمَنِ اخْتَلَفَ فِيهِ Anyone who goes against the Prophet, either within Islam or he leaves him in totality by leaving Islam, فَمَا اخْتَلَفَ فِيهِ وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا And become groups, أي فِرَقًا كَأَهْلِ الْمِلَلِ وَالنِّحَلِ Like the groups and the sects. وَهِيَ الْأَهْوَاءِ وَالضَّلَالَاتِ فَاللَّهُ قَدْ تَبَرَّأَ رَسُولَهُ Allah has freed his messenger from those people. مِمَّا هُمْ فِيهِ That which they are upon. وَهَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ كَقَوْ وَهَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ And this ummah as well. So this ayah, according to Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala, and also before Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, they took that this ayah refers to the Muslims as well. Brothers, I want you to analyze this ayah because there's a powerful matter, which inshallah ta'ala I'm going to elaborate on it more later. Allah tells us, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا. Those who have differed in their religion and they became grouped. The question that arises and opposes itself or comes up is the ummah going different, having different views in the religion is something that's going to happen. The Sahabas did. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Abdullah ibn Abbas disputed on the ayah أَوْ لَمَسْتُمُ النِّسَاءَ. Abdullah ibn Abbas believed that the lams here is meant by jima', sexual intimacy. Whereas Abdullah ibn Mas'ud believed that it's mujarrad al-lams, just by the mere touching. So according to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud's understanding of the ayah, أَوْ لَمَسْتُمُ يَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ فَاغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقِ, the part, last part of the ayah, Allah says, أَوْ لَمَسْتُمُ النِّسَاءَ, or you touch a woman, from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud's qawl and Abdullah ibn Abbas's qawl, two different views come out of it. According to Abdullah ibn Mas'ud's qawl, it comes as any person who touches a woman, she breaks his wudu. And according to Abdullah ibn Abbas, it wouldn't unless sexual intimacy occurs. So two views come and there is a differences in their view. Is this what the ayah is referring to? La. How is it not? There's something in the ayah you to underline, which is what? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ. That's not madhmum fi haddi ذَاتِهَا. To differ in the religion is not something that is blameworthy in and within itself. Guess what is when it's blameworthy? وَكَانُوا شِيَعًا. We become groups. That's when it becomes praiseworthy. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, did he have a group that followed him and said, we're carrying the flag of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and we're the ones who believe this? Is that what they said? La. Did Abdullah ibn Abbas say the same? La. They all had that views in that matter and they were what? And they were still had wudd al-mahabba. And inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to talk about the khilaf that occurs in the usul and the furu', of course, that needs to be looked into. But I'm talking about nowadays you find a masjid may pray more than 11 raka'at tarawih, and another masjid may pray 11. And a group would say, our masjid pray this much and your masjid prays this much. Try to make two groups out of it. Two groups, each group is the 11 raka'at masjid and this. La. These are masail that is khilaf stands. And to make it into a group, and to make it into a sect, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah in his kitab Qawa'id al-Nuraniyah, he says that person is a hizbi, that person is, who tries to make matters which the ummah are allowed to differ in, and the difference was way before us, and it will forever stand, to make it, or where you place your hand. A person puts his hand on his chest, and another one puts it in his stomach, and another puts it in his navel. You can have a view which is strong, and you can say this is the strongest view. Like to divide the ummah on this matter, or who puts his knees down first, to make it where we believe we could put our knees down first, and you don't believe it, this is not matters from the religion. And you make it groups, you fall under this ayah. So what we do is, you believe you could put your hands down first, you believe you could put your knees down, we can discuss it if you want. Like when we stand up and if we differ, you have the ra'i and I have this view and we're allowed to. And it's mimma yasughu fihi al-khilaf. And it's from those things which khilaf can occur from. Naam. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ فَرَّقُوا دِينَهُمْ وَكَانُوا شِيعًا لَسْتَ مِنْهُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ يُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ. There are also many ahadith regarding ذَمُّ التَفَرُّقِ. Allah تبارك وتعالى says, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه في صحيح مسلم, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith which I narrated, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْضَى لَكُمْ ثَلَاثًا وَيَسْخَطُ لَكُمْ ثَلَاثًا, which I read. Also there is another hadith, Abu Huraira narrated in صحيح مسلم. The Prophet said, من خرج من طاعتي, anybody who gets out of obedience, وفارق الجماعة, leaves the jama'ah. The jama'ah, Imam al-Shatib in his kitab al-i'tisam, he brings many views what jama'ah is meant by. Views. But the jama'ah is meant by the Muslims in their, as a whole and their leader. Anyone who cuts up from them. فمات, and he dies. مات ميتة جاهلية, that person will die a death of jahiliyah. الإمام القرطبي in his kitab المفهم لما أشكل في صحيح مسلم. Remember, there are two Qurtubis. There's one Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi and Abu Abbas al-Qurtubi. The one who done the sharh of المفهم لما أشكل في صحيح مسلم is Abu Abbas al-Qurtubi and he's the teacher of Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi. He's his teacher. He said, the hadith من خرج من الطاعة وفارق الجماعة, He said, "Ta'atu bi ta'atu wulati al-amri wa bil jama'a." And this is what concerns us. Wa bil jama'a, the jama'a is meant by jama'atu al-muslimina. He leaves the Muslims. He cuts off from them and stands by himself. Good. On what? Jama'atu al-muslimina ala imam. The ummah have all united upon this person as a leader. You come and you cut off his, I don't agree. Aw amri mujtama'in fi alayhi. Or a matter in which they have all come together. They believe in this matter. They've all united and you cut off from them. If that person dies, mata meetat in jahiliyyah, he will die the death of jahiliyyah. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, Imam Tirmidhi narrated, you can say Tirmidhi or you can say Turmudhi. Both ways are correct. That's how you say his name. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man arada, anyone who wants, bahbuhat al-jannah, anyone who wants to enter Jannah, فَلْيَلْزَمِ الْجَمَاعَةِ Stay with the jama'ah. فَإِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ مَعَ الْوَاحِدِ Shaytan is with one. وَهُوَ مِنَ الْإِثْنَيْنِ أَبْعَدْ And it's far from two. The more the number becomes, the more shaytan is further away. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام. Brothers, what's the natijat al-tafarruq wal-iqtilaf? What is the results that we get if we disunite and we become groups and sects? The first one is إخواني وَلَا شَكَّ وَلَا رَيْبِ is adab, punishment. And guess where the punishment comes to us from? Our own selves. We will make each other taste pain. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this ayah came down on him. قُلْ هُوَ الْقَادِرُ عَلَىٰ أَن يَبْعَثَ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابًا Allah is the one who is able to send on you a punishment. مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ from above. وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِكُمْ from beneath your feet. Allah is able. أَوْ يَلْبِسَكُمْ شِيَعًا Or Allah makes you into groups. وَيُذِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَأْسَ بَعْضٍ And group of you make the other group taste pain. انظر, Allah says, look. كَيْفَ نُصَرِّفُ الْآيَاتِ Look how we turn over the matters and we clarify the issues to you all. لَعَلَّكُمْ يَفْقَوْنَ So you guys can come and think and ponder of what's being said here. So the Prophet ﷺ, three things has been said to him. And all the time, he was saying, أَعُوذُ بِوَجْهِكَ Oh Allah, I seek refuge in your face, Ya Rabb. He was saying. All of the others, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he will not punish us with one punishment that's going to come on all of the ummah at once. No. That won't ever happen. Maybe Allah might punish a group somewhere and the other punish the group won't. Muslims might be punished on one قطر من أقطار الأرض, a part of the land, we might be punished there, a group here, a group there. Like in one adab, one punishment that encompasses all the Muslims, it will never happen. But guess what will happen? To be put into groups and firaq and ahzab and sects, and then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, وَيُذِيقَ بَعْضَكُمْ بَأْسَ بَعْضٍ And we make each other taste pain. Fulan says this about you. Look what Abdullah ibn Abbas said about this ayah. He said, أي فرقا وأحزابا يكفر بعضهم بعضا ويقتل بعضهم بعضا. How are we going to make each other taste pain? We're going to make كف تكفير of one another. You're a kafir. And ويقتل بعضهم بعضا. And then what, after that, straight away after the takfir comes killing. Because he's a murtad. And then the person will kill the other. Abdullah ibn Abbas said that. I finished the first part of ذنب التفرق. How much time do I have left? 10 minutes. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to quickly talk about haqiqatu ikhtilaf. What's the reality of ikhtilaf? What does ikhtilaf mean? Ikhtilaf, brothers, is two types. There's ikhtilaf which is mahmood and there's ikhtilaf which is madhmoom. Ikhtilaf which is praiseworthy and there's ikhtilaf which is not praiseworthy. What is the dabit for the ikhtilaf which is madhmoom and what's the dabit for the ikhtilaf which is mahmood? Meaning, how can I distinguish between one and which is which? The ikhtilaf occurs from two places. Qawl, three places. The ikhtilaf occurs from the speech, the i'tiqad, and the amal. If the ikhtilaf is an ikhtilaf which is by speech, we differ by one another by speech, but the basis of both of us, the i'tiqad and the asl we're picking up from, is the same. But what we're differing upon is an interpretation which is allowed within the boundaries of the sharia. It is not an interpretation where you bring whatever you want. The khilaf is within what? Boundaries which are set. Then that person's ikhtilaf is this one. No problem. That ikhtilaf can occur in what? That ikhtilaf can occur in furu' al-masail, matches which are fiqh. They can occur in it, which they are the most that occur. Ikhtilafu fil aqa'id ama fil usul, ikhtilaf, differing, and everyone having his own understanding of aqidah, that's not tolerated in the sharia. Are you with me? And within the sharia, there is kulliyat and there is juz'iyat. If the person agrees with us in the kulliyat, the general principles of the aqeedah, but there happens to somehow he differs with us in a sub-branch of aqeedah, scholars also have given excuses to him. But they haven't allowed the differences of that issue. But they excuse that particular person. And they don't take him out of the fold of Ahlul Sunnah. What I mean by it will become clear. The khilaf occurs, brothers, in usul and furu'. If the khilaf occurs in the usul, it's not tolerated. And evidence for that is Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam al-Dhahabi, go to Sir Ala bin Nubala, the fifth volume, Mu'assasatul Risala, the publication Mu'assasatul Risala by Shu'ayb al-Arnaut. Get the Kitab al-Sir Ala bin Nubala, by Imam al-Dhahabi. Fifth volume, first tarjama, the first biography is Imam al-Dhahabi, Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. The first biography is who? Shafi'i, Muhammad ibn Idris al-Shafi'i. Pages after, 6-7 pages later, he brings a speech which Shafi'i said. Shafi'i said, Wallahi by Allah, la'an yufti al-alimu, for a scholar to give fatwa, fayuqala, for it to be said, akhta al-alimu, that this scholar got it wrong, khayrun lahu, is better for him. Min ayyatakallama, then for him to talk about, aymata, fayuqalu, he then is said about him, zindiqun, he's a person who left the religion. وَمَا شَيْءٌ and there is not a matter أَبْغَضُ إِلَيَّ مِنَ الْكَلَامِ وَأَهْلِ there is not a matter that is more hated to me than أهل الكلام and his people. Shafi'i has just told us here, before I reach what Dhahabi said right after that, Shafi'i has just told us right now that there is a matter, if a person does a mistake, we will only say أخطأ فلان, he got it wrong. And there are matters, if he does, what do we say? زَنْدَقَ, he said. Which is, he leaves the religion because of that mistake. Shafi'i, the Habib straight away put a footnote on it. He said, Ta'liq, he said, هَذَا دَالُّ This is an indication. عَلَىٰ أَنَّ مَذْهَبَ أَبِي عَبْدِ اللَّهِ That Imam with Abi Abdullah, bin Muhammad Idris al-Shafi'i's madhab is what? أَنَّ الْخَطَأَ فِي الْأُصُولِ A mistake in the usul, لَيْسَ كَالْخَطَأِ فِي الْإِجْتِهَادِ فِي الْفُرُوعِ It's not like a mistake if you do in a matter ijtihadiyya, which is furu'. Imam al-Shafi'i didn't believe that. So we realize from here that the differing that occurs is because people differ in something. If the differing is based on a matter which is fara', it's a fara' matter, ijtihad, then we always say is rajih and marjuh. Akhta'a fulan, and you, the other person will say about you, akhta'a, labas. As long as we don't become shi'an and ahzab, there's nothing wrong with that. Lakin usul, when we differ in matters which are usul, in and within itself, that it in and within itself is what? That in and within itself is madmum. Imam al-Shatibi is going to give us a good understanding of what it means to do a mistake in usul. In his kitab al-i'tisam, Shatibi says, وَذَلِكَ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْفِرَقَ إِنَّمَا تَصِيرُ فِرَقًا When would a group become opposite to Ahlul Sunnah? That they're not part of it anymore. And they are a group that stands just like Ahlul Sunnah stands. And they are opposite to them. When does that happen? Shatibi said, وَذَلِكَ أَنَّ هَذِهِ الْفِرَقَ إِنَّمَا تَصِيرُ فِرَقًا It becomes group بِخِلَافٍ لِلْفِرْقَةِ النَّاجِيَةِ Opposite to the saved sect فِي مَعْنًا كُلِّ When they oppose them in a general rooted principle قَاعِدَ كُلِّيَّةِ They oppose them in a particular field. And there are five matters, inshallah ta'ala, that I'm going to mention. مَسَائِلُ الْأَسْمَاءِ وَالصِّفَاتِ مَسَائِلُ الْقَضَاءِ وَالْقَدَرِ مسائل الأسماء والأحكام مسائل الصحابة and مسائل الوعد والوعيد those are the five things every books of عقائد talk about any of those five which I'm going to bring later إن شاء الله تعالى مسائل الأسماء والصفات مسائل القضاء والقدر مسائل الأسماء والأحكام مسائل الصحابة and مسائل الوعد والوعيد those five a person for example does not like the Sahabas does he go against you in a fundamental matter الأمر الكلي he goes against it this he now automatically stands shouldered he's opposite to فرقة الناجية the safe sect why? Because one of the رؤوس one of the matters which makes you أهل السنة which is a matter which is أصل he's going against it في الدين وقاعدة من قواعد الشريعة لا في جزئي not in a sub-branch what does he mean by a sub-branch? The sub-branch can be two things شاطبي means The first one, it can mean that the person agrees that the Sahabas are what? Are virtuous. And he respects all the Sahabas. But what does he say? He says, I believe that Ali should be given precedence to Uthman This is a mas'ala juz'iyya. Ahlul Sunnah have differed in it before, and that person cannot be taken out of Ahlul Sunnah. But is he wrong? Ahlul Sunnah says weak view. But if he says, I'm going to put Uthman, I'm not talking about virtue, I'm talking about leadership, khilafah, virtue, not khilafah. Talking about virtue. He says, I see Ali more virtuous than Uthman. Ahlul Sunnah have differed in that matter. Abi Abdullah, Ahmed ibn Hanbal was asked, a person who says that, do you take him out of Ahlul Sunnah? He says, la. Between who? Ali and who? Uthman. But then the person says, no, I put Ali before who? Abu Bakr and Umar. This is Amrul Kulli. Does that make sense? Amrul Kulli. La fil juz'i. The second meaning that the juz'i can mean, the juz'i can mean is masail fiqhiyya. Fiqh matters that they differ with you on. Good. إذ الجزئي والفرع الشاذ لا ينشأ عن مخالفة يقع سببه التفرق الشيعا وإنما ينشأ التفرق عند وقوع المخالفة في الأمور الكلية لأن الكليات تقتضي عددا من الجزئيات غير قليل وشاذها في الغالب ألا يختص بمحل دون محل ولا باب دون باب. It's what I've explained to you guys. Due to the short time, I have to go over it quickly. And I'm just going to give you one example and I'm summarizing all this. That the Salaf Ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in, there was a time when a mistake occurred in a matter which was juz'i in a matter of aqidah. And they gave example. Like the matter of the Sahabas putting Ali before Uthman is a matter of aqidah. But it's a juz'i, it's not a kulli. And Imam al-Dhahabi in Sir Alam al-Nubala, rahimahullah, and these they're called Ahadul Usul, or you could call it Daqa'iq al-Masail, or you could call it juz'i. All three of these names are given. Idhahabi said about the tarjama, the biography of Abu Ibn Khuzaymah. Ibn Khuzaymah, Imam al-A'imma. You guys know Ibn Khuzaymah, right? The author, the scholar who wrote his Sahih. Idhahabi said about his biography, he said, وَكِتَابُهُ فِي التَّوْحِيدِ. Ibn Khuzaymah has a book called Kitab al-Tawheed. مُجَلَّدٌ كَبِيرٌ, it's a big volume. وَقَدْ تَأَوَّلَ فِي ذَلِكَ. In that book, he has translated, he has interpreted Hadith al-Surah, the Hadith of the Surah. There's a particular Hadith called Hadith al-Surah. خَلَقَ اللَّهُ آدَمَ عَلَى سُورَةِ الرَّحْمَنِ. He is interpreted in a different interpretation. فَلْيُعْذَرْ. He's excused. Ah. This is مسألة of عقيدة, right? It's باب الأسماء والصفات. He said فَلْيُعْذَرْ. He should be excused. Why? مَنْ تَأَوَّلَ بَعْضَ الصِّفَاتِ. He is interpreted, he is excused. Anybody who interprets a particular hadith regarding the characteristics, the attributes of Allah, one characteristics he says, I'm going to give him a different meaning to it. Then it's apparent meaning, but the asr he accepts that all Allah's characteristics should be left at its apparent meaning, without any how or without any resemblance. But there's one particular characteristics he pulls it to a particular meaning. He should be excused, he said. وَأَمَّا السَّلَفُ. Then he refutes him, because his still view can be refuted. فأما السلف فما خاضوا في التأويل بل آمنوا وكفوا وفوضوا علم ذلك إلى الله ورسوله. And then he goes on to say, ولو if أن كل من أخطأ في اجتهاده, everybody who does a mistake in his striving, مع صحة إيمانه, and he has good intention, وتوخيه لاتباع الحق, and he's trying hard to follow the حق, أهدرناه, we put him down, وبدعناه, we call him a مبتدع, لقل من يسلم, it will be little for those who are saved for us, من أئمتي, from the scholars. There will be little. رحم الله الجميع. May Allah have mercy upon all of them. بمنه وكرمه. One of the scholars who did that is Mujahid ibn Jabr. Sufyan al-Thawri رحمه الله تعالى, he said, إذا جاءك تفسير مجاهد فحسبك به. If the tafsir of Mujahid comes to you, that's sufficient for you. Mujahid is the one who said, عرضت المصحف على ابن عباس in ثلاث عرضات. I opened the Mus'haf on Abdullah ibn Abbas three times. أوقفه عند كل آية. I stopped him at every verse. I said, Ibn Abbas, what does this verse mean? What does this verse mean? What is this? Three times. Finish again. Finished again. Finished three times. So Sufyan al-Thawri said, if the tafsir of Mujahid comes to you, فَحَسْبُكَ بِهِ, that suffices you. Mujahid, when it came to the ayah, وَجُوهُ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٍ إِلَى رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٍ. The word nadira means that we're going to look at Allah the day of judgment. He said, تَنْتَظِرُ ثَوَابَ رَبِّهَا. Waited for the reward of Allah. He's interpreted عَلَى غَيْرِ ظَاهِرِهَا, other than its apparent meaning. But the asr is, Mujahid accepts the characteristics of Allah should be left at its apparent meaning. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, I know I promised that was going to be the last quote. And this is going to be honestly the last quote. And Imam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah, he said, Ibn Taymiyyah, he had a dispute, he had an argument when he wrote his kitab, Aqidatul Wasatiyya. He had a debate, but this is what he said after the debate. Because they tried to say that Ibn Taymiyyah, which is a very common statement that he said about him, that Ibn Taymiyyah, he does takfir on anyone who opposes his belief. Ibn Taymiyyah did it. And Ibn Taymiyyah makes bid'ah of everyone who opposes his belief. Ibn Taymiyyah does it as well. He'll say himself. So they said to him, okay, Ibn Taymiyyah, do you believe that your book, Aqidatul Wasatiyah, anyone who doesn't stick to everything that is in there is a mubtadi' and a dhal and a mudhil? He said, this is what he said. Walaysa, no, no. Walaysa kulla man khalifa fi shay'in min hadhi al-i'tiqad. No. In the case, this, he's speaking for himself. Walaysa, and it is not. Kulla man khalifa fi shay'in min hadhi al-i'tiqad. Anyone who opposes me in this book, my Aqidah book, Aqidatul Wasatiyah, yajib an yakuna halika, that person is destroyed. No. It's not the case. فإن المنازعة, because the person who's arguing with me or is opposite to me, قد يكون مجتهدا, he might have اجتهاد, he might be striving, مخطئا, who done wrong, يغفر الله خطأه, Allah will forgive him for his mistake, وقد لا يكون بلاغه في ذلك, the matter may have not reached him, من العلم ما تقوم به عليه الحجة, the proof has maybe not reached him for the evidence to be established on him, وقد يكون له من الحسنات, maybe he has righteous actions, ما يمحو الله به سيئاتي, that Allah may wipe away from him his shortcomings. He might have good acts of good obedience, that Allah will wipe away from him his shortcomings the day of judgment. And Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, this is what he's saying with his own speech. So inshaAllah ta'ala, due to the short time, I will conclude there inshaAllah ta'ala. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
استمسك بحبل الله استمسك بحبل الله
Hold tight to the rope of Allah Hold tight to the rope of Allah